You know, after 8 months of extensive renovation and expansion, a Central City institution known for giving youngsters a hand up has officially reopened its doors.
That's right. Lunch is officially served again at Cafe Reconcile, bigger and better than before. My story takes us inside the new and improved restaurants that helps teenagers who may be at risk. It's a story all new at 6.
From top to bottom, it's a brand new Cafe Reconcile. The renovations are massive. What used to seat 80 now seats 240.
We went from 2,400 square feet to 17,000 square feet. We literally renovated every square inch of this five-story historic building. We also purchased the property to the left of us.
Not only does the expanded place serve lunch inside and outside, there are also two new state-of-the-art training kitchens, off-street parking, and banquet space for large groups or parties.
So a red bean and a baked dark is going to sell me with a meatloaf.
It has upstairs space to provide job training. The goal here is to take kids who may be at risk and give them skills they can use in the future.
You know, we changed the model a little bit from a culinary training program to a hospitality industry training program.
19-year-old Devontae Lee is part of the Cafe Reconcile program. He is from New Orleans East.
It's beneficial to me for growth and to meet a lot of people, social networking, so in the future I can talk to them later about starting a business and they can help me out and give me advice.
Lee says his time here has impacted his life.
There's crime and murder and people doing drugs and selling drugs, and I believe this stands at the pinnacle of change.
After all, the idea here is to help those
who are looking for a career path, not just a beginning job or a dishwasher job or a waiting tables job, and that's where they're going to stay. And the ones that do that, they stay that, they may be happy, but these young adults are looking for that career path.
Really great program there, and that program expects to graduate 120 students this year. The goal is to triple that number by next year.